Karl's Eastern War is coming to a close. After a few years of attempting to clear Chaos Champion Morkhal-Hai the Savage's forces out of the Borderlands, Karl has finally come face to face with the champion's personal warband. Years of war with the followers of Chaos has made Karl realize that the average man is not enough to stop them. So in anticipation of this clash with Morkhal-Hai, he has raised an elite army composed of the finest soldiers in Reichland. He has also left the comfort of the saddle for the battle, and is joining his personal greatsword bodyguard, believing that his presence in the thick of the fighting will push his men to victory.
Hey everybody, it's Overkill here with another Total War, a Warhammer historical battle. So, this is the final battle of the Eastern War. Karl's attempt to clear these Chaos Warbands out of the Borderlands, which is basically the land right next to the Empire, which is in the Border Princes Confederacy. So that's where we're going to be fighting today. I tried to get a map that kind of represented just Eastern Europe, kind of, in general, because that's kind of what the Borderlands are like, is kind of like Russia a little bit. I don't know. The maps are very limited in this, which is kind of makes me sad, especially for maps for when we do the third Battle of Blackfyre Pass. I'm not going to be able to actually have a Blackfyre Pass map, which kind of sucks, because, well, Blackfyre Pass, as you've seen in the trailer for Total War Warhammer, is pretty damn impressive. But we'll make do. We'll have epic battles, at least, on less than epic maps. But anyway, as you can see, like in the intro, this army is composed entirely of elite troops, so we have a bunch of great swords, a solid line of dismounted Reichsguard, so you can see them, just look at them, aren't they awesome? Karl Franz's personal bodyguard, greatsword bodyguard, so you can see him right there, although that's obviously not him, but I decided to use Karaberg greatswords. You can ignore the fact that they're from Karaberg, because Karaberg is in, like, oh, what city is it, or what state is it? Oh, crap, it's not Nordland, I don't think, but, yeah, ignore the fact that it's that. I just wanted a unit with better stats than the normal greatswords, and they look cool, so. Then we have four units of handgunners, of course, because they punch through armor like it doesn't even exist. And then there's more greatswords. And then we also have mounted Reichsguard. And cannons. It can't be Empire without cannons. So anyway, let's move over to the Chaos side. So you can see that they have Marauders, Chaos Knights, Chaos Trolls. Ooh, spooky and very ugly. Chaos Warriors with Halberds. Now, there is no information on who Morkhal-Hai actually was. I assume with the name The Savage, he was either Khorne, like I've based here, or maybe Undivided, but I decided to go with just all Khorne stuff because, well, why not? Khorne's cool. So we also have some Chaos Ogres along with the usual Halberds and Chaos Warriors, and then there's that and that, and then more Marauders and more Knights, and then Morkhal-Hai's unit himself, the Khorne Chosen, so they look pretty cool, don't they? And there's the man himself right here. And I mean, Chosen, Khorne Chosen are a perfect unit to represent someone with the name The Savage. I mean, they're wearing armor, but like you can see their chests and their arms are exposed, and they also have demonic feet, but we won't look at that. But yeah, anyway, let's get right into this battle. So, first thing, our cannons are going to start loading up their cannonballs. And we're going to watch as the first volleys rip through the enemy ranks. But, like I was saying, there's not too much information on this stuff. We know how the battle ends, which is with Karl Franz personally charging into Morkhal-Hai's not bodyguard, but getting into a fight with him and personally crushing his head with Galmaraz. But sadly, we can't give Karl Franz Galmaraz in this because of the limitations of Medieval 2 and the mod. But you can see the cannonballs just ripping through, killing dozens of Chaos Warriors. Also hitting the ogres as well, which is pretty nice. So a cannonball just hit that ogre, like, directly in the face, which is always fun. But yeah, sadly there's not much information. Of course, the next battle is going to be the third battle for Blackfyre Pass, and that has plenty of information. I'm actually going to attempt to recreate that battle as accurately as possible. Now, for anybody that doesn't know about the third battle of Blackfyre Pass, I won't spoil too much. But there's going to be Karl Franz and his Reichland army. There's going to be Marius Lightdorf and an Averland army. And then there's going to be either two or three orc armies. So that's going to be a bit of a crazy battle. So I'm not going to spoil what happens in that battle because it is pretty crazy. And it's going to be a real pain to try to attempt to recreate that. But I'll try my best. So you can see as they're slowly approaching, they're just taking all kinds of fire. Our handgunners have started lighting them up. Our cannons are still just pouring down fire into them. We've actually taken out a few trolls at this point. Or ogres, rather. You can see some ogres died back here. Which is good, because ogres are scary, and they're big and tough. And also, they don't look like this anymore, thankfully. If there's ogres in Total Warhammer, oh, it's going to be so cool. I love ogres. But yeah, you can see we're just taking pot shots at them, basically. You can see scattered around everywhere are assorted chaos troops as they are shot down either by cannons or handguns. And I love hearing the pitter-patter. I love hearing the sound of the bullets punching through the plate armor that these guys wear, like that, just that loud, like, psh sound as it just punches right through. It's great. Also hearing them yell in pain is nice as well. Yeah, you can see they've crested the hill here, so now these handgunners have a perfect shot. So we'll watch as they volley. Boom! But this is where the Chaos Warriors begin their charge. They've had enough of being shot at. They're charging right in. But you can see we got a few explosive rounds into those ogres, which actually disrupted their unit. They actually started moving around pretty randomly. But you can see the trolls managed to catch my handgunners like they always do. Arr. Damn trolls killing my handgunners. But yeah, the Reichsguard have formed a shield wall, so no matter the strength of any Chaos Warrior, they can't get through there. But yeah, you can see the trolls don't care much for that. Karl's unit is right here. I was going to engage them with those trolls, but I figured if Karl died early in the battle, that wouldn't exactly be right. So I decided against that. You can see I started moving Reichsguard around, or Reichsguard Knights around here, attempting to charge into these guys, but I just couldn't get the angle on them. I've also started moving a unit of Reichsguard Knights over here, as they're going to start doing hammer and anvils with the greatswords and the Reichsguard, dismounted Reichsguard, rather. But you can see that we're not doing too bad. We've lost 13% of our men already. That's mainly due to the trolls being a bit of a pain. And now the ogres are charging in to make it all worse. Look at that. They just charge right through, just flattening people. Which is quite crazy. We went from 13% to 16% just as quick as that. But the enemy have, of course, lost more men. And I believe in this battle they had more men than me anyway, so that actually makes it, man for man, it's even higher, or even better for me. So you can see now we're swinging around with this unit of Reichsguard, and they get a nice charge right into these Chaos Knights. Nice. So they kill a few of them. But I see these warriors with halberds are charging in, so I try to get out of there, I believe, unless I don't really pay attention, which I probably didn't, because you guys know me. As soon as I charge something in, I tend to just forget about it. You can see we charge in with knights over here as well, which is nice. These guys are still just chilling over here, just waiting, looking at the hill. They're like, oh, that's a pretty nice view. Perfect. We went 24 and 32 right now, so that's not too bad. Of course, that might be just marauders that we've killed so far, because it usually goes like that. Because you can see that there's not that many marauders. Here's a unit here. So a lot of them have probably already died, which wouldn't be much of a surprise. You can see I moved this Reichsguard unit back, and they're just going to keep doing cycle charges, basically, until we can kill all those guys. So let's watch as we get a pretty nice charge here. Boom. That dropped a lot of the knights. Excellent. But yeah, you can see at this point in the battle, the enemy force was already almost to 40%, which is pretty good. And I was getting pretty scared at this moment because our numbers are actually catching up to theirs. We're 31%, they're 39. That's not good. And you can see I really haven't been paying attention to this unit. They're still in the same position. Don't worry, I do move them. Don't you fret. I noticed my center was becoming very weak due to these trolls. Look at the path of destruction they've made in my lines. They've just bowled right through. They've just made a pass through my men just to go through. But you can see I charge my Reichsguard Knights in, and they actually do very well against the trolls. They actually killed one, I believe. Yep, the lances just stuck right through that guy. You can see I finally moved this Reichsguard unit that's over there. And we slammed into the ogres. I think I actually managed to kill a couple there doing that. But yeah, the knights are over here. They're just chilling. But we finally managed to reach nearly 50% casualties to the chaos forces. You can see these ogres just absolutely destroyed this unit. This unit's dead. How sad. They've just been absolutely destroyed. They fought for the Emperor. They fought for the Empire. They'll be never forgotten. So we get a good charge into the ogres with my Reichsguard Knights. You can just see that they just flattened the ogres. They actually killed a bunch of them. When we last looked at them just a few moments ago, they were at like 20-something ogres, I'm pretty sure. So you can see that did a lot of damage. And you can see that this flank is starting to get very weak for the Chaos Forces. Due to my rear charges and just the fact that these units are awesome. The Great Swords are an amazing unit. They just cleave through anything. Doesn't matter what it is. But yeah, it's basically just the same thing across the line. We're just getting some nice hammer and anvil charges on the Chaos Forces. Which is affecting their morale quite nicely. Which is excellent. You can see that Morkhal-Hai has engaged himself over here on this flank. His Chosen haven't actually gotten into the fight. They're just back here, I don't know, supporting, yelling at people. Maybe killing some of their own guys to inspire each other, I don't know. Khorne cares not where the blood flows as long as it flows, or whatever the saying is. Can't quite remember exactly what it is. But you can see now I'm charging this unit of Reichsguard Knights into these guys. In an attempt to, well, break this unit and, of course, do some damage to the trolls while I'm at it. And it is pretty successful. It's a successful charge. You can see I attempted to run my Reichsguard Knights away, and I just started moving them there. So we're going to get them to swing around and then charge into these guys. So let's watch as that happens. Here it comes. Take them out, boys. Yeah, look at that. Look at them go flying. You know you're a powerful unit when you send a Chaos Warrior flying. All right, here's another charge coming in on these guys. Which should actually be enough to break some of them. Because we just flattened. Yep, there you go. The Marauders. Actually, no, that's a... Yeah, the Marauders broke. Right. Excellent. Then they start fighting to the death because I've blocked them in completely, which isn't good. So I decided to run away. And you can see that Morkhal-Hai has disengaged himself from the combat now. And he's behind the lines. Basically just getting ready to engage somewhere. So I was going to charge him, but then I realized what unit it was. So I was like, oh, well, I don't want to get involved with the Chosen with my Cav. I could have done a lot of damage, of course, but it was better to just let him run in. You can see that we actually broke the Chaos Ogres. That's pretty cool. So basically now we're just finishing off these last few halberds, and then these units will be swinging around. And yeah, Morkhal-Hai has actually engaged himself right in front of Karl. So I start lining up his Greatswords unit so that we can actually go charge into that unit. Which is pretty good. And of course, in typical fashion, the AI can read your mind. So as soon as I started getting Karl ready to charge in, he ran away. So I do decide to charge into this unit, I believe. Or at least maybe I was planning on it. And then I just let them walk right into them like an idiot. Not quite sure. Yeah, I was going to charge them. Then I guess I wasn't paying attention, so they walked right into them. Don't worry. I make up for that. Yeah, you can see there's not many Chaos Forces left now at this point. The only thing that's really keeping this bar so high is the fact that they still have their trolls. It's like 65-45 in my favor. It's basically just because of the trolls that it's even that close. But you can see now charging into these warriors with halberds, just absolutely flattening them. And here we go with the with Karl's personal greatswords charging into the Chosen. How epic is that? So they're fighting. Look at that. Just swinging and chopping away at him, but it doesn't matter. One swing from the Chaos Chosen just took him out. He got two good swings on that Chosen, and the Chosen just takes one swing with his axe and kills him. Pretty good. Morkhal-Hai is realizing that he's lost this battle at this point, so he's trying to... He's trying to retreat, but there's no getting away from the fury of the Emperor. I decide to pin him down with my cavalry, I believe. From both sides, I believe I charge with these Reichsguard knights. And then I get Karl and his bodyguard in it there. You can see that I've started to walk them over, getting ready for a nice charge. And yeah, 93% of the enemy forces are dead. It's basically down to the trolls and then the couple dozen men that are still here. But we don't want to miss this battle with Morkhal-Hai. Look at this. The unit of dismounted Reichsguard, the unit of Karaburg Greatswords, let's go! And at this moment, Morkhal-Hai is slain. I would like to believe that it would be the Greatswords unit that killed him, but I'm pretty sure that he dies from the Reichsguard, sadly, in this battle. But we can imagine that Karl Franz delivered the final blow. But yeah, you can see he died there. I think it might have actually been a Greatsword, because I couldn't see a Reichsguard actually swinging at him. So we'll just believe that it was historically accurate, and Karl Franz delivered the killing blow. Let's believe that. So yeah, basically that's really the only units that are even left on the field other than the Chaos Trolls. And they're still here being a real pain, slaughtering my loyal Reichsguard. But you can see I'm literally just piling everybody in here now. I'm starting to swing my knights around to try to get charges in on them. And you can see that there's only 17 chosen left, so that's good. Oh, I was actually looking for charges on the chosen, it seems. And then I realized how little men they actually still have. This didn't stop me from charging him in, though. But yeah, there you go. You can see now the Chosen were slaughtered to the last. Possibly around the body of Morkhal-Hai. But it does not matter. There is the last one. A sword driven down through his shoulders from a horse. Perfect. And now begins the long grind of killing these Chaos Trolls. They have no sense of... they have no sense of fear, no cowardice. I don't know. They basically they're just killing as much as they can because they don't even realize where they are. Probably they are just in full kill mode. They don't realize that all the other forces are gone, and they're just surrounded by Imperial forces just hacking away at them. So if we turn this up to 2x speed, because of course you can see there's still plenty of time left of the battle. This grind isn't working, as you can see, so eventually I decide to move the cavalry out of the fight. I move Karl out of the fight for sure, because don't want a troll accidentally stepping on him or maybe chopping him in a couple pieces with their axes and swords. And I pull out all my Reichsguard, and I start actually giving orders to my handgunners to start shooting at them. So you can see that a few of them listen to that order, but it's kind of glitchy where they're a gun unit and they're firing into a melee. They get a little iffy on that. If they don't have direct line of sight, sometimes they won't shoot at the guys if there's like enemy units in the way. Which is fine, I guess. It saves you from having a bunch of friendly fire. But now you can see this is where I start shooting at them and charging in with all my Reichsguard knights. Basically just getting ready to slaughter this unit. So here's a good charge with the Reichsguard knights. I believe it actually kills one of the trolls. Yep, you can see that one over there died. Excellent. And yeah, we're basically just getting everybody ready to kill these guys, because they are just absolute beasts. They will not go down. There you go, one of them dies. A few too many swords in the organs, probably. But yeah, basically I'm just probing around this mosh pit, basically just charging my cavalry in where I can, trying to directly hit one of the trolls. But yeah, you can see that there we go. We've actually managed to bring them down to 4 trolls. And just like that, the battle is over and we have a clear victory. So we lost over half of our men, sadly. They will all be missed, of course. Their sacrifice to the Empire was very important to Karl. Securing the borderlands, basically. Although they were not his lands, as they were in the Border Prince's Confederacy lands. But it secured the eastern part of the Empire from being raided and destroyed, possibly. And yeah, this is only a little bit of time away from the Third Battle of Blackfyre Pass, which is very close to the Empire. If there was no victory at Blackfyre Pass, there would be no Empire, basically. But yeah, guys, Be sure to leave a like and a comment down below, and make sure to smash that like goal that I set for this episode so that we can have the third Battle of Blackfire Pass as soon as possible. But yeah, this has been Overkill as always, guys. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next battle. Anyway, goodbye.